Today we have the 880 indicator and we will be walking through configuration and calibration. So as you can see now, at 0 millivolts, we are currently sitting at negative 205 pounds. If we crank it up, we go off the spectrum at 2.0 millivolts. So what we want to do is actually configure this for a 5,000 pound scale, counting by 1 pound, and we will go up to 3 millivolts. So first we're going to access the menu. Now, as long as this is not locked with a configuration password, you will be able to go over to the right to setup. If the setup menu is locked out, you will have to access the physical configuration switch. The switch is available in the lower left-hand corner on the bottom of the unit. As you can see right here, if we push the button, we will access configuration. Notice I am using a plastic tool. Please make sure to never stick metal inside the indicator, as you could chip a board and cause issues. From there you drop down, and here we have the scale's parameters. This is where we will configure anything that has to do with the scale. So as we drop down again, grads is our first available option. Since we are doing a 5,000 pound scale by 1 pound, our graduations will be turned down from 10,000 to 5,000. Now we come to the split parameter. That is unneeded. We will move on. Formatting. This is the format. We often use the term count by. The count by is actually the decimal location multiplied by the division. So if we drop down here, we see primary. This is the primary units the scale will be using. Again, we drop down. Here we come to the decimal point parameter. If we drop down again, as you can see, there is currently no decimal point available. If we scrolled to the right, we could get 0 if we wanted to count by 10, 20, or 50 pounds. Or, if we go to the left, we get 0.8, which actually indicates point of whatever division size you have. So we would count by 0.1, 0.2, or 0.5. That can be pounds, kilograms, whatever your units happens to be for the primary divisions. So, as it was already set up the way we needed it, we will accept this. The next is display divisions. If we drop down here, we have several available options. We can count by 1 division, 2 divisions, or 5 divisions. If we were setting up, say, a truck scale, we would actually use 2 divisions with a decimal point location of 0. This would give us 20 pound divisions, or whatever we happen to be using at the time for our units. With 20 pound divisions, if we're going to 120,000 pounds, it would be 6,000 graduations. The way we determine this is 120,000 divided by the 20. That is our count by, and that will give us our graduation size. So we will accept this because it is currently what we are looking for. Units is where you can set your primary units. All other units will be based on this unit. So if we drop down, it is currently set to pounds. We will leave it set this way, as this is what we are going for. Now, as we go back up to primary, back up to format, now that our format has been configured and our graduations have already been determined, we will scroll over to calibration. Calibration is where you perform the W0 and W span of an object, which is a 2-point linear calibration. There are more available options, which we will go into in other videos. As we drop down here, we have the W0. This is the point where, at the dead load of the scale, you want your zero reference point to be. If we hit enter here, it will show us our current counts. This was the counts that was for the previous W0. If we hit enter now, it will go into calibration. If we go back, we can actually see that our number has changed. This indicates that the zero point is now at 122,928 counts. So we will go up. WVAL, this is where you set the weight that you're going to be putting on the scale. Since I am calibrating with the full 5,000 pounds, I will drop down. This is 10,000. Currently, you put down, right, and then we will go up to 5. After you hit enter the first time, it then allows you to choose a decimal point location. So if you're going to 500, you could move it like that, or even 50,000, that is available. However, for this demonstration, we are only calibrating to 5,000. We will now hit enter, and it moves us to our W span. At this point, you would put all weights that you are using onto the scale in order to calibrate the span point. The span point needs to be at least 10% of the scale's capacity, but it's often recommended to use as much as possible. We will now add the weight to our scale, press enter. Again, this is our current span counts, so in order to determine our new counts, we must press enter. Now, the W linearity is another form of calibration where we can add multiple weights in increments, whatever you happen to be using, but you have 5 available points. We will go back, W span, and drop down. We can see our number has changed. Now, this number does actually go to the right, but unfortunately, the screen can only fit 6 digits. Now that our calibration has been performed, we will save and exit by hitting the menu button. Now that it comes out of calibration, we can see the full span weight is still on there. If we turn it down, we see that our zero reference point has been established correctly. At this point, you are completed with calibration and configuration. Thank you very much. This has been Rice Lake Weighing Systems' demonstration of calibrating and configuring a 880.